ਤੇ ਬ੍ਰੇਕ ਤੋਂ ਬਾਅਦ ਸਵਾਗਤ ਹੈ ਜੀ। ਗੱਲ ਕਰ ਰਹੇ ਹਾਂ ਲੰਡਨ ਐਲਾਨਨਾਮਾ ਜੋ ਕਿ ਕੱਲ੍ਹ ਹੋਇਆ ਲੰਡਨ ਵਿਖੇ, ਔਰ ਪੰਜਾਬ ਰੈਫਰੈਂਡਮ 2020 ਜਿਹੜੀ ਤਜਵੀਜ਼ ਹੁਣ ਰੱਖੀ ਜਾ ਰਹੀ ਹੈ, ਇਸ ਮੁਤਲਕ ਵਿਚਾਰ ਵਟਾਂਦਰਾ ਸਾਡਾ ਜਾਰੀ ਹੈ। ਮੇਰੇ ਨਾਲ ਸਟੂਡੀਓ ਦੇ ਵਿੱਚ ਮੌਜੂਦ ਨੇ ਨਵੀਨ ਸ਼ਰਮਾ, ਸਾਡੇ ਮੈਨੇਜਿੰਗ ਐਡੀਟਰ ਫੋਰ ਜਸਟ ਹਿੰਦੀ, ਅਤੇ ਨਾਲ ਅੱਜ ਆਪਾਂ ਵਿਚਾਰ ਵਟਾਂਦਰਾ ਇਹਨਾਂ ਨਾਲ ਵੀ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ। ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਕਰਾਂਗੇ ਕਿ ਅਸੀਂ ਜੋੜ ਚੁੱਕੀ ਹੈ ਸਾਡੀ ਟੀਮ ਅਦੱਪਾ ਪ੍ਰਸਾਦ ਨੂੰ, ਜੋ ਕਿ BJP ਦੇ ਓਵਰਸੀਜ਼ ਦੇ ਵਾਈਸ ਪ੍ਰੈਜ਼ੀਡੈਂਟ ਨੇ, ਅਤੇ ਨਾਲ ਹੀ ਐਡਵਾਈਜ਼ਰ ਔਨ ਕੌਂਸਲਰ ਅਫੇਅਰਸ ਮਿਨਿਸਟਰੀ ਆਫ ਐਕਸਟਰਨਲ ਅਫੇਅਰਸ ਦੇ ਬੁਲਾਰੇ ਵੀ ਨੇ, ਜਾਣਨ ਦੀ ਕੋਸ਼ਿਸ਼ ਕਰਦੇ ਕਿ ਇਸ ਮੁਤਲਕ ਉਹ ਕੀ ਕੁਝ ਕਹਿਣਾ ਚਾਹੁੰਦੇ ਨੇ। ਅਦੱਪਾ ਜੀ, ਵੀ ਵੈਲਕਮ ਯੂ ਇਨ ਆਰ ਸ਼ੋਅ। ਅੱਜ ਦਾ ਮੁੱਦਾ, ਆਈ ਵੁੱਡ ਲਾਈਕ ਟੂ ਹੈਵ ਯੂਅਰ ਓਪਨਿੰਗ ਕਮੈਂਟਸ ਔਨ ਪੰਜਾਬ ਰੈਫਰੈਂਡਮ 2020 ਐਂਡ ਦੀ ਡੈਕਲਰੇਸ਼ਨ ਹੈਲਡ ਐਟ ਲੰਡਨ ਯੈਸਟਰਡੇ।
ਥੈਂਕ ਯੂ ਵੈਰੀ ਮਚ ਥੈਂਕਸ ਜਸਟ ਪੰਜਾਬ ਫਾਰ ਹੈਵਿੰਗ ਮੀ ਔਨ ਦਿਸ ਅੱਜ ਦਾ ਮੁੱਦਾ। What I would like to say is, Six for Justice, led by Gurpatwant Singh Pannu, is taking up a wrong cause in at this juncture. And unka actions jo hai, wo koi inke piche koi hai, koi aur mulk hai jo Bharat ko vichhinn karna chahta hai.
Specify kariye, kaun sa mulk hai?
I do not know because I do not have any concrete information. But there is some evidence, and the experts are saying that there is a country, it could be our neighboring country, which is very much interested in the division of India, and that is what their ambition is. And SFJ is basically playing into that hand, because when they are saying all these things about Khalistan and all that, then why don't they ask Anandpur Sahib, Gujranwala, Lahore, Peshawar, Gilgit and Baltistan, Khyber Pass, that in log claim kar sakte hain? Aisa kyun nahi? Aur in log, why they are going against the tenets of Sikhism? When you look at that, Guru Tej Bahadur aided Kashmiri Pandits in avoiding conversion to Islam and was arrested by Aurangzeb. So, kya unko ye charitra, ye history malum nahi hai unko? Why are they doing it now on a wide scale, on a international platform, whereas the actual Punjab is against it? And no Sikh or Hindu or whoever residing in the present state of Punjab in India wants this. And if they want it, why don't they ask for the greater Punjab? Because it was divided between Pakistan and India. So why don't they ask for the other side? Anandpur Sahib wahan par hai, Lahore wahan par hai. So aisa kyun nahi pooch rahe hain? Iska matlab
they are saying their statements, they want to start from India and later on they can decide for Pakistan also.
So why don't they start from Pakistan and they decide on India? Yeah, why not?
Okay.
So that is my comment on that. What they are doing is wrong, and they are actually trying to destabilize India. They are playing into the foreign element's hands, and they are not thinking about the Sikhs in India. They are thinking about themselves as a diaspora outside.
Sir, but as per their statement, they are saying, as per the media reports, those who are saying that, you know, lots of Sikh diaspora was there yesterday at London Declaration, and they supported this Punjab referendum 2020.
Yeah, so when they have 2,000 people, is that Indian? Is that a Sikh diaspora? Is that you call it as a Sikh diaspora when you mobilize people and let them go there? That is not true strength of what they are calling. It is all sham, funded and aided by foreign elements. And that is for sure.
So what do you want to say? They're going to have some events like this in future also. So even the UK government supported this London Elanama, this London Declaration 2020. So why you don't think that this London Declaration has been stopped by the UK government? UK government ne kyun nahi roka isko?
Ye UK government se hi puchna padega, humko nahi malum, because UK government, whatever they gave as a justification, as a freedom of speech. Yes, in a democracy, everybody has a freedom of speech. Anybody can say what they want. There is nothing wrong with that. And democracy means is for demonstration and protest and also supporting the government and all those things.
Sikh for Justice,
we understand.
Sir, Sikh for Justice says that the Sikh and the minorities in India, they are not safe. What would you like to say on this?
They are wrong. And that's why I'm saying, if they are saying that, that means they are definitely playing into the hands of foreign elements. Because what were they doing when Manmohan Singh, who is a Sardar and a Sikh by himself, and who is representing a party that killed and basically did a pogrom to kill and eliminate Sikhs in India, why didn't they raise their head during that time? That is my question. My sincere question, actually.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And P.V. Narasimha Rao was there. B.N. Singh was there. Right now, Amarinder Singh is there. So Congress government is ruling the same Punjab which actually killed Sikhs. So what do you say about that? What would Gurpatwant Singh Pannu would say that?
So they have their statements. They say that the minorities the government or by the Modi government, they are not building that confidence level into the Sikh minorities. So they feel unsafe living in India. That's why they are migrating to other countries like UK, Europe, New Zealand, Australia, Canada. So they say that we want Khalistan, we want referendum 2020 to be happen so that the Sikh diaspora can decide about their separate country, Khalistan.
So, actually, Sikhs are more safer since the BJP government headed by Narendra Modi came into existence. Since he took the oath of office, he is the one first to meet with Sikh diaspora, and he actually facilitated the fulfillment of most of their demands, and the rest of the demands are also being considered. So he is the most Sikh-friendly prime minister. And if SJ, Sikh for Justice, saying that means they are wrong. They are definitely aided by some elements because they are saying lies. Because Sikhs were getting away from India during 1984 to 1996. They are not getting away now. They are getting away. Most of them got away from 1984. So whatever they are saying, that they are wrong.
And okay, sir, hold on.
When you ask me question, let me finish. So as a Sikh person, not a reporter, you tell me when did they went away from India, most people during 80s or 80s and 90s or in 2000?
Okay, sir, let's not talk about referendum now. Let's talk about the Sikh genocide 1984. Modi government said, when he became prime minister, he said, I'm going to make the SIT, I'm going to make the case reopen, and I'm going to make the culprits behind the bars. So where is that decision now? Where is that statement now? Where is that justice now? Okay, let's not talk about referendum 2020. Let's talk about the justice for Sikh.
Okay, so you don't know what is happening? You are asking me or you want to tell?
I just want you to tell what is happening, sir.
Yeah.
Aap bataiye na ki kya ho raha hai.
So, sabko malum hai. The cases are reopened. That is universe. It came in the newspaper. I don't need to say it because I also live here. And the cases are at the Supreme Court. So, this is the first time since so many years that the Congress government basically closed and a lot of the eyewitnesses died. So why do they delay? They delay because the eyewitnesses die. So definitely the injustice is done by Congress government. So as soon as Modi government came, they actually worked on that. And a few months ago or 1 year ago, they opened these cases. Now they are at the Supreme Court level. And they are pursuing these cases. So it is monitored and maintained by the Supreme Court right now. So they will get justice as long as Modi government is there.
Sir, अब चलिए मैं एक आपसे सवाल जाते-जाते और पूछ लूं, मेरे पास समय नहीं है. What would you like to say on Punjab referendum 2020? I would like to have your closing comment on this now.
Thank you very much for providing that opportunity. But what I'm saying is that is really wrong. I mean, they should not do those referendums and all those things against the wishes of the Punjab people. And this is definitely a choreographed event done by a very minuscule or low number of people associated with the Sikhs for Justice. The reason reason I'm saying that is I have also witnessed this same thing in Washington, D.C., also in front of the White House. There are a few people who are definitely, they want to pursue this without rhyme or reason. And that's all I wanted to say. And Modi government is actually, they are working on the justice for Sikhs. They have opened a
Sikh diaspora is waiting for that justice, sir. They are waiting. They want to see the justice, and they want to see the statement of Narendra Modi that he had given when he became Prime Minister of India. He said, "I will stand next with the Sikh diaspora, whether they are living in India or whether they are living in abroad." And they are even waiting for that justice. So let's see.
Yes.
Now you are saying it is between the Supreme Court now. जो मानियों का अदालत फैसला करेगी वो सबको मानना पड़ेगा लेकिन लेट्स सी व्हेन दिस सुप्रीम कोर्ट ऑफ इंडिया विल मेक अ स्टेटमेंट एंड दे विल इशू यू नो करिकुलम और दे विल इशू अ जस्टिस और समथिंग दैट द कल्प्रिट्स कैन गो बिहाइंड द बार्स
एब्सोल्युटली दैट इज व्हाट वी आर फॉर टू एज इंडिविजुअल एंड आल्सो रिप्रेजेंटिंग द पार्टी एंड आल्सो रिप्रेजेंटिंग द एंटायर इंडियन डायस्पोरा. Believe me, from the bottom of our heart, we want justice for Sikhs.
चलिए सर, देखते हैं, तस्वीर साफ करेंगे, फिर लेकर आएंगे आपको वापस मुद्दे के ऊपर.
Thank you very much.
ऐसे के अदप्पा प्रसाद बीजेपी ओवरसीज दे वाइस प्रेसिडेंट सी के जिन्होंने अपने प्रतिक्रम देते रेफरेंडम 2020 नु लेके. तो फिलहाल मैं हूँ एक वक्फे ले रुक रहा, लेकिन मैं वेख पा रहा कि इतने काफ़ी सारे कॉलर्स मैंने कॉल करना उन्होंने शुरू कर दिता है. लवांगा तुहाड़े कॉल्स भी और तबसरा भी करांगा नवीन शर्मा जी के नाल. फिलहाल इस ब्रेक तो उस पार.